Hello everyone and welcome back to another Star Wars action figure review. Today I'm going to be going over the Black Series 6-inch speeder bike with Biker Scout. Absolutely love this thing, and if they go on sale, I'm definitely going to try to get one or two more. I'm also hoping that they decide to make a pack or separate figures of Luke and Leia on Endor so we can make a little scene out of this. So, fingers crossed in the near future. But for now, let's go ahead and take a look at the actual figure first. I'll show you guys the bike soon enough. Zoom in. The detailing is just absolutely great. I think they did an awesome job on him. I mean, they did say the Black Series 6-inch, they were going to do a lot of good detailing. Especially on the boots here. He has that discolored look, which is correct, of course. You're on the moon of Endor, gonna walk in the ground, get dirt all over your boots. There are some areas where it feels rushed, especially that little place there, but other than that, they did a great job. There's that little red stripe. And in terms of articulation, he's very good. He has a ball jointed neck with the hinge, so you can ball hinge shoulders, though it's a little restricted by the shoulder plate. Then below it, it's just swivel. Double hinged elbows. Ball hinge wrists. A ball jointed upper torso, but it is restricted because of these pouches mostly. Ball jointed hips, then below that, swivel, double hinged knees, if I can get it, there, and the boots can swivel, then ball hinged and swivel ankles. So yeah, very nicely articulated, especially for the speeder bike. Now, the only accessory he came with besides the bike, and if you want to count the display stand, is his little blaster pistol. And surprisingly enough, this is the whole issue I have with the one issue I have with the entire pack. This little blaster pistol. Reason number one. I think it's too small. I mean, seriously. I swear in the movies it was a lot bigger. Let me know what you think in the comment section, but yeah, to me it's just too small. And secondly, I can show this. It's broke. I can't remember if I broke it when I took it out or it was already broke. But on the bottom, it's actually starting to break off as well there too. So if I try to use it, it might completely break off. So if you get one, be extremely careful with this blaster pistol. Seriously, I'm not going to even call Hasbro and see if they can replace it. They're probably all going to be the same. Now, you can fit it on the little holster on his boot. Of course, it won't stay in there that well, so you'll probably need the elastic band that is used to secure it. Still, it's not bad. I mean, I like it. Again, just wish, and I think it should be bigger, the blaster pistol itself. Now, we move on to the actual speeder bike. Now, this thing is incredibly detailed. It's just, I think it's flawless and perfect, myself. You do have silver paint applications to signify wear and tear. I mean, they just did an absolutely great job capturing every detail on this bike. Now, the only things that work on here are the flaps, which I was kind of surprised they did, but Hasbro has a tendency to surprise once in a while anyways. And for some reason, they decide to make the pedals removable. Not sure why, maybe it's so you won't break them off or something, but yeah. And then the little gun underneath can swivel 360 degrees. And it's also soft plastic, just like the little gun. So, yeah, careful of that. And the handlebars, they don't do anything except stay right in the same place. Now, the display stand itself is actually unattached when you get it, and it's not hard to take out or put in. It's just a ball. Now, unfortunately, it's no big deal. I'm going to have to cut away to show you guys the Biker Scout on the bike, because this is going to probably take a while. Plus, I do want to show you something really cool you can do with this display stand. So, be right back real quick. Okay, so I got him on the bike, and as you can see, it just looks awesome. I mean, I absolutely love speeder bikes and Biker Scouts, so definitely works. Show you what he looks like in 360 degrees motion. Okay, so the one thing I wanted to show you guys for sure for this display stand, let me see if I can scoot back a little further. The fact that you can do all sorts of crazy poses, so if you wanted to do something like that, you can do it. Or maybe just completely, like, there's no almost limit. It's just crazy. I mean, you can't do every single direction, but the fact that you can do something like that, it won't tip over, or just completely up, or, like, if I had, let me just actually do this. Don't know how well that would work, but, yeah, but for the most part, something like that. I mean, he's really tilting, and he's not falling over. And then, the last part, of course, is the packaging. Hello! Do you have a picture of him in the top corner? There's the bio if you wish to pause the video and read. And then a nice little wash on the back of him. Just really, really cool. Well, guys, that's all the time I have for this Star Wars figure review. Until next time, Admiral, alert my Star Destroyer to prepare for my arrival.